Searching databases? What does that mean? What's the difference between Ebsco and ProQuest and Gale? What's the difference between Academic Search Premier and Business Source Premier? Where do I find all these? Well, a database is like a catalog or an index. It's a list of articles, but it's also searchable. Rather than just listing every article in alphabetical order, like a dictionary, you can search through a database by keyword, or by the name of the article author, or by the name of the journal the article is from, or several other search strategies. You can even combine these search strategies, like searching for articles that are about kayaking and written by Tom Jones, or maybe search for all articles written by Tom Jones for the journal Sports Psychologist. Let's take a peek at a couple of databases and talk more about them. From the Harrison College LRC Home, choose the Databases tab. This has a long list of all the different databases we offer. All the databases are listed in alphabetical order below. There are many databases and each has some special focus. Some databases contain only articles related to health sciences, and some contain only articles related to business, and so on. Some databases are called general databases. They contain articles for many different subjects, but the total number of articles is lesser than a specialized database. For example, in the general database Academic Search Premier, there might be 20,000 articles on business, as well as 20,000 on health and 20,000 on literature, and several more on other topics. But in CINAHL, which is a health sciences specialized database, you will find over 100,000 articles in the health field, but you won't find any on business or literature. Depending on what you're searching for, you can choose a different database, or even more often, you can try them both and find different things. Each database also has a special interface. That's what we call the actual view that you are working with. EBSCO is one of the most widely used interfaces. The same EBSCO interface is used in multiple databases, like Academic Search Premier, CINAHL, and several others. If you know how to use one EBSCO database, then you know how to use them all, even if they have totally different articles within the database. Other interfaces include ProQuest and Gale. These interfaces may look slightly different from EBSCO, but really they have many of the same features, just organized in a little different way. Let's look at some. Here we will start with the EBSCO database Academic Search Premier. Here's the start screen. Let's do something simple. Just search for articles with the keyword kayak. Look at that. 5,000 articles with that keyword. If you want to narrow it, only find articles with that keyword but written by the author named Jones, we can try that as well. For the database to search for the word Jones as an author name and not just a keyword, we'll change this select a field option to author. Okay, that's more like it. 21 results. Now we can browse through the articles. Let's jump out of Academic Search Premier and check out another database. Here's one called ProQuest Newspapers. This will contain only newspaper articles from the New York Times and other publications, but little or no journal articles.
As you can see, the interface looks a bit different. You have three choices: search all newspapers in the database, search just New York Times, and search just the Wall Street Journal. But these are just quick search options. So, as a savvy searcher, you can click on the advanced search here to see more features that you might recognize. Multiple search boxes here, options to change the search field here. Let's see what it looks like if we just type the word kayak here and search. Okay, over 2,000 results, and all from articles from newspapers that contain our keyword.
Let's move on to another database. How about a Gale database, Science in Context? Notice how this interface is a bit flashier than EBSCO and ProQuest. This features more graphics and topic suggestions on the start screen. You can click on one and follow the path to a suggested article. Or you could do a simple keyword search in the search box at the top, or even choose the link Advanced Search to give you more options in specialized searching like we saw in the EBSCO and ProQuest interfaces. There are many more things to learn about databases, but this is a start. Go ahead and give it a try yourself. The more you experience it hands-on, the better in searching you will become. Good luck!